As mentioned in my previous video on Typhoon Kamiji Lewis, there are more consecutive microwave anomalies that occurred between 160 East and 175 East, which will eventually become another low-pressure typhoon. Let us watch it first. More succeeding rectangular anomalies was observed between longitude 162 East and 175 East. This rectangular anomalies produces dark clouds which will eventually become another low pressure, or perhaps another typhoon. Now, let us analyze again the clouds after the first and second microwave pulses. First pulse. This clouds becomes darker and moves slowly westward. Second pulse. Some clouds moves westward and merge with the clouds here. Most of the clouds moves eastward and merge with the clouds near 170 degrees west. This band of clouds are thick and could become another typhoon. Let us hope it will not become super typhoon. Let's go back to September 10th before the first pulse occurred, and see how Feng Wang started. First pulse. Second pulse. Here we can see that the clouds move slowly westward and started rotating, but the center is not well defined. Boom, another microwave pulse occurred. 8 hours later, the first advisory was issued on September 17th at 12 Zulu or UTC. The center was located in 12.8 north, 130.8 east, winds at 30 knots. Status: tropical depression. Since the disappearance of microwave pulse on September 11th at 6 a.m. UTC, we knew already that another tropical depression will be born 6 days later. The clouds that came from a microwave pulse became tropical depression Feng Wang. Yet another system is on the way. The dark clouds east of the microwave pulse that is clearly visible on microwave images on September 17th at 4 p.m. will likely become a low pressure to tropical depression. Let's hope it will not be another super typhoon. Let's watch it closely, and clearly how Feng Wang started.